When I came home, my husband, Tyson, was already home, and my younger sister, Beth, had also come. Beth, you're here.
Yes.
Hey, I have something important to talk with Tyson today, so could you leave?
We also need to talk to you, Caroline.
Huh? We?
Caroline, I want a divorce.
Excuse me?
Well, actually, Beth is pregnant with my child.
What? My name is Caroline. I am 28 years old, and I work at an office. I met my husband, Tyson, when he was a business partner of mine, and invited me to dinner. And from then on, we began to meet up and go on dates frequently together. He proposed to me, and we got married. We have been married for 3 years now. We sometimes fight, but we are not on bad terms. We both love kids, and I'm sure we will be able to build a good family once we have kids. However, despite these thoughts, we have not been able to have any kids. We have been trying to have a baby since we were newlyweds, so it should have been possible for us to have a child sooner. However, the fact that we could not have a baby, even after 3 years of marriage, made me a little uneasy. So I decided to talk to my husband about fertility treatment. Hey, Tyson, we've been married for quite a few years now, and I think it's time to seriously think about having a baby.
What? Seriously?
Well, I'm talking about fertility treatments and all. When I said this, my husband had a stern look on his face.
But infertility treatments cost quite a bit of money, don't they?
You don't have to worry about that. We have money saved up. Both of us still work, so we can afford it.
But it'd also be difficult for you physically, won't it?
That's true, but we still want to have a baby.
Aren't you being a little hasty?
Huh?
Even if you are over 30 years old, and even if you are in your 40s, people still get pregnant. I don't think you need to force yourself to have a baby now.
Tyson certainly has a point. I have a younger sister who is 7 years younger than me, and my mother had my sister when she was 34. When she gave birth to my sister, my parents had no particular intention of having a second child. But even so, when she gave birth to me, at the age of 27, she was doing a lot of things to have a baby, doing what we would now call fertility treatment. Since I am already 28 years old, beyond the age my mother gave birth to me, I can't help but feel impatient and want to get pregnant as soon as possible if I can. But I still think I want a baby now.
We don't even know if we're infertile in the first place, so I don't know if we should suddenly start treatment.
Then how about getting tested? When I said this, my husband looked a little annoyed.
Huh? An examination? You don't need one. I definitely don't think I'm infertile.
How can you be so sure?
That's because, you know, they say that women have a higher chance of infertility.
I was a little offended by this statement. What? So you're trying to say that I'm infertile?
I'm not saying you are. But it is a fact that female infertility is more common than male infertility. Men may cheat on wives a lot more, though.
Don't tell me a stupid joke at a time like this. It's true that women are more infertile than men, but I've heard that men are infertile too.
I am not infertile. I've never had any serious illnesses, and I'm perfectly healthy. In any case, let's have dinner soon.
With that, my husband changed the subject. But I was serious about discussing what was on my mind with him. Maybe my husband and I have different ideas about procreation. I felt a little sad, but I was sure that what my husband was saying was not completely out of line. He told me that it was normal for people in their 30s to be pregnant, and that women were more likely to be infertile than men. Feeling frustrated that I couldn't properly talk back to him, and also thinking that, of course, that there was a possibility that I was the cause, I decided to take a fertility test. That day, I got a paid leave in advance at work and went to take a fertility test. And when the test was over around noon, I decided to go into a cafe in town and have lunch alone. Then, by chance, I saw my younger sister, Beth, in the cafe. My sister was having tea with a guy about the same age. However, both of them looked kind of serious. Then they both got up and were about to leave the store. At that moment, my sister noticed me and came over to me.
Oh? Is that you, Caroline? If you were there, you should have called out to me.
Yeah, but you looked kind of serious with your boyfriend.
Did you hear what we were talking about?
No, I just got in here a little while ago.
I see.
My sister told her boyfriend, who was waiting behind her, that she was going to go talk to me for a bit and made him leave first, then sat down across from me.
Oh, are you sure?
I mean, about your boyfriend.
It's okay, it's okay. I was just going home for the day anyways.
Well, I mean, he wasn't the same guy I saw about 2 months ago.
That's right. Did you break up with the last one already?
That one, yeah. I think I broke up with him.
What do you mean, you think? Well, as long as I'm happy now, that's all that matters.
You should think a little further ahead about your life, you know.
But I'm still a college student. I want to have as much fun as you can before I become a corporate slave.
A corporate slave? I guess it depends on the company. If you study hard, earn credits, and job hunt, you have a better chance of getting into a company that treats you well.
Oh, come on, sis. Don't be like Mom. Can I go over to your house today?
What? Why?
Because if you're here today, that means you're off work, right? Which means you have time to cook, right?
Well, it seems I don't have a choice. I'll make you something you like.
Yay!
I spoil my sister so much as if she were my own daughter, since she's way younger than me. Although my parents do discipline her to a certain extent, she's the youngest, so they let her have more freedom than they did when she was my age. After that, I stopped by the supermarket with my sister, came home, and proceeded to prepare dinner. Then, my husband came home around 7 p.m.
Oh, welcome home, Tyson.
Oh, hey, it's you, Beth. I didn't know you were coming.
I came over for my sister's dinner today.
Well, it's going to be lively.
My sister had come over for dinner several times before, and because of her friendly personality, she and my husband quickly became good friends. The three of us had a nice meal and we all had a few drinks, but halfway through the meal we ran out of drinks. So I lost in a game of rock, paper, scissors, and I had to go to a nearby store to buy some.
Oh, I want some ice cream too!
Me too!
Okay, ice cream, drinks, and snacks. I took my wallet and left the house. And when I came home after buying the things, my sister was gone. Hey, where's Beth?
Oh, she got hot, So she's taking a shower right now. She wants ice cream after her bath.
Goodness, she really gets to do whatever she wants, huh? Oh yeah, I had my fertility test today.
What? You seriously took the test?
Because I wanted to be sure. The results should come out in a few weeks.
So, what if you find out that you're infertile?
If they say we'll never be able to have kids, I'll give up. But if the chances of having children are low or something, I'd like to have fertility treatment.
Seriously? You were that serious?
What, you don't want to have a baby with me?
I do, but I don't want to go through the infertility treatment.
I see. Maybe you and I have different ways of thinking fundamentally. Then my sister came out of the bath at this point, so the conversation ended there. After that, things became a little awkward between my husband and I, and we spent more and more time in silence. Then the test results came back, so I went to the clinic after work. Then the doctor made a surprising statement.
Upon the test, you're not infertile, so you can get pregnant without any issues.
Oh, really?
Yes. So if you can't get pregnant, you might want to have your husband come in for an examination to find out.
Okay, I understand. I felt relieved to find out that I was not infertile, but worried at the same time whether I would be able to continue married life with my husband. If I was not the cause, then there was a high possibility that my husband was the cause. My husband was not likely to be willing to undergo tests and fertility treatment. It is true that I have become a little disappointed with my husband because of this incident. I was worried that if we were to have a baby, he would not put our family first as a husband and a father. But for now, I had to report the test results to my husband. Then, we would discuss what to do. When I came home, my husband Tyson was already home. And my younger sister Beth had also come. Beth, you're here.
Yes.
Hey, I have something important to talk with Tyson today, so could you leave?
We also need to talk to you, Caroline.
Huh? We?
Caroline, I want a divorce.
Excuse me?
Well, actually, Beth is pregnant with my child. So, I'll divorce you, and I'll get married to Beth.
What? It was so sudden that I couldn't catch up with what was going on.
Oh, Caroline, I'm really sorry.
It's not your fault, Beth. It's because I was weak. And if we have a child, I have to take responsibility.
Tyson!
Seeing the two of them start flirting in front of me, I felt somewhat really angry. In general, just having physical relationship with your own wife's sister is disgusting. But being in a relationship with a college student who is way younger is just not possible. My affection for my husband was gone in an instant. Oh, I see. So, we're getting a divorce and you're going to get married to Beth. But why don't you do whatever you want? But I'll make sure I get alimony. My husband and sister were surprised that I backed down so easily, but said,
"Well then,"
and handed me the divorce papers. I quickly filled them out, packed my belongings, and quickly left the house. After filing the divorce papers on the same day, I went back to my parents' house and reported the matter to them. My parents heard about it and were outraged. They immediately called my sister and declared that they'd cut off ties with her. My parents were so outraged that they reported this to my ex-husband's parents. My ex-parents-in-laws apologized to us and cut ties off from Tyson. I then demanded alimony from Tyson and my sister. However, my sister is a college student, so my husband paid the entire amount. Thus, I left my husband, cut off my sister, and started a new life. 2 years later, I married one of my colleagues. To my surprise, we soon had a child. 3 years later, I was walking the streets with my husband and my daughter when I was suddenly approached by someone.
Oh, Caroline?
What? Oh, Tyson.
Long time no see. How have you been?
Oh yes, it's been a long time. My ex-husband glanced at my now husband and at my daughter and grinned.
I didn't expect you to remarry.
I told my current husband to go ahead and take my daughter and walk out first.
And you remarried a man with a child. That's quite a step.
I went through the sarcasm and asked my husband a question. Well, what about you? Are things going well with my sister, whom you cheated with while you were married to me? My ex-husband looked bitter when I said this.
Beth, she spends a lot of money and doesn't do any housework at all, so it's really difficult for me.
Well, I guess it must be. I never saw her doing any housework. She also had all her boyfriends pay most of the bills for her.
You know, the baby she gave birth to looks nothing like me at all. I wonder if the baby is really mine.
Well, probably not.
Excuse me?
I forgot to tell you that the day you and I broke up, I was told that there was nothing wrong with me after a fertility test.
Excuse me?
To prove it, the daughter my husband has now is my own daughter that I gave birth to.
No way!
That's why you are most likely infertile. My ex-husband's face turned pale all at once. Also, actually a little after you and I divorced, I bumped into my sister's boyfriend at the time.
Boyfriend?
We talked for a while and he told me that Beth had told him that she was having a baby, but she didn't know whose it was.
What?
So she was just looking for someone to marry and provide for her at the time. And thought that you'd be a great option, I guess.
Oh no. So I've been with someone else's child?
Well, I don't feel sorry for you at all, since it's your fault for being unfaithful like that. Well then, I have my precious husband and daughter waiting for me, So, I'm going now. Goodbye. My ex-husband watched me leave in a daze. I don't know what happened to my ex-husband and Beth after that, but I'm sure they must have gone through quite an argument. Well, I don't really care because it is no longer my business. Meanwhile, I am getting along very well with my current daughter, my husband, and my family of three. My home will be completed soon, and we will move into a new house. I am looking forward to starting a new life in a new home with my husband and daughter, whom I love. Thank you for watching until the end. Please subscribe to our channel. See you in the next video.